This video will show you how to submit a model for MD Nastran analysis using Patran 2010. So here in Patran, I have my model where I've created my finite elements, I've applied loads and boundary conditions to properly constrain and load my model, I've also created material properties, and then applied them to the model through element properties. So now I'm ready to perform my finite element analysis. So under the Analysis tab, I can see that I have options to analyze the entire model, a selected portion of my model, or just to simply create the analysis deck or input file for MD Nastran. In this case, I want to perform a full analysis and analyze my entire model. This sets the action, object, and method to analyze entire model full run. I'll be performing an MD Nastran structural analysis. I can scroll down here on this form and click on solution type. And the solution type form is where I actually define what type of analysis will be performed. In this case, I want to perform a linear static or solution 101 analysis, but this is where I would select if I wanted a solution 103 normal modes, or buckling, or any of these other types of solution. Now, each of these solution types has their own solution parameters, which are accessible via this form. And you can basically make changes to the specifics of the solution and the options available to you using this form. Here, the only real change that we've made is we've defined a weight mass conversion. This means that when we defined our density, a weight density was used instead of a mass density that Nastran would be expecting, so we need to enter a conversion factor. And we can do that via this weight mass conversion on the solution parameters form. So we can click OK there. And then we have the option for direct text input, where we can actually add text to be passed to our MD Nastran solver. We won't be doing that in this case. And we won't be using any super elements. But next we'll click on the subcases form. Here we can see all of the load cases that we defined in our model. Again, load cases allow you to group different sets of loads and boundary conditions together to model different loading situations in your model. So here I have two different load cases, this front torsion and static inertial loading, and those have been converted into subcases. And for each subcase in Patran, I can define additional subcase parameters, output requests, direct text input, or select explicit multipoint constraints. I don't need to be doing any of that here, but I will, however, analyze each of these load cases so I can basically perform two analyses in one. And using the subcase select button, this is where I choose which of my subcases will be analyzed in a given run. In this case, I want to run my front torsion and static inertial subcases, but I'm not interested in my default. So these selected subcases will be analyzed separately as part of my MD Nastran run. So now I'm ready to analyze my model. I'll go ahead and enter a specific job name. So all of the files for this analysis will contain this job name. So I'll go ahead and click Apply. Now what Patran does here is writes out my Nastran input file and actually starts Nastran and begins the process of performing the analysis. Once the analysis is complete, Nastran finishes and I can return to Patran. My next step is to take the data that Nastran generated as part of that analysis and attach the results into Patran so that I can continue with my post-processing. Under Access Results, I can choose XDB. This is the results format that was generated by that run. And I can choose to select my results file. I have the Sandrail Analysis 1 XDB. I can click OK and apply. And now I can see, it's always a good thing to see in the comments that the results file ended and that was successfully attached. That indicates that I now have results that I can go on and post-process using Patran. So I've submitted my analysis, you know, I've modified my parameters, got it set up how I wanted, submitted it to Nastran, had Nastran run it, and now I've brought the results back into Patran. And just to verify that, I can click on results and see that I now see these different result cases available, one for each of the subcases that I ran as part of that analysis.